What is up, YouTube? It is your boy Dominzs here at Common Sense Graphics, and today in this video, I'm going to be talking about why you should pick one drawing tablet over the other. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about the Wacom Intuos Pro versus iPad Pros and other screen digital ink tablets, but let's get into the video. So I first want to start this off by talking about my first impressions of using both the products. I've used Intuos Pros and I've used iPad Pros, and I've also used the Cintiq Companions, and they're all great tablets. There's nothing bad I can really say about either or. This video is more catered towards what you should pick when you're either beginning or what you feel like you are ready for an upgrade for. And my first impression using the Intuos Pro is that it's very nice, very fun to use. It's as a learning curve at the beginning. You're definitely going to need to learn how to use it. It's not going to be easy when you first begin, but after that first month of, you know, sketching and drawing and things like that, it's going to click with you sooner or later. You're going to understand how to draw on the pad to your computer screen. And to some people, it is a challenge. And to me, it was a challenge, but after I figured it out, it became very enjoyable. I am an illustrator. I draw in Illustrator, and I absolutely love the way how it feels, and the strokes are very nice, but sometimes the strokes don't always come out the way I want them to. Sometimes they just pop out a little differently than what I expect, and sometimes it can be difficult using it just because I'm used to, you know, looking down onto the paper I'm drawing on instead of looking up at my screen. And so trying to get my eyes and my hands synced up together like this was quite a challenge, but after you got it down, it was amazing. But let's talk about drawing on a screen like my iPad, for example. Drawing on screen was a hell of a lot more easier to get used to than drawing on an Intuos tablet, just because it felt more natural when I was drawing on it. Things just happened to come together. I got used to the pressure sensitivity real quickly. I was able to adjust settings to make the stylus work the way I like it to work. And after I got everything figured out, it just became real simple. It just snapped, and I understood it, and I just loved it. And there's nothing bad I can say about it. And I think everyone should at least give it a shot, give it a try to see what you like better. And I'm probably sure everyone's going to always say that they like drawing on the screen better just because it's more comfortable, more natural feeling than versus drawing on an Intuos Pro style tablet. And I do recommend that. There's definitely, to me, my differences when using these tablets is that when drawing on screen, my strokes are more clear, they're more straight, they're more streamlined versus on the Intuos Pro, where they might be a bit more jagged, might be a bit more loose, or they just don't look as clean as that they would on a screen drawing tablet. But let's get into the next segment, and that is going to be the software. To me, software really matters. If you're drawing on something like an iPad Pro, you're very limited to what you're able to do because you're not able to use the full arsenal of software a computer can pack. So you might want to go the Cintiq route. But in this sake of the video, I'm going to be talking more about the iPad than the Cintiq, okay? So using Adobe products are just amazing. There's a lot of products out there. There's Adobe products, there's Affinity Pro products, and there's just a lot of stuff out there. Me personally, I do enjoy the Adobe products just because there's so many there available, and they're really easy to get your hands a hold of, and I really do enjoy it. There's so many features. There's a lot of things I can do in comparison to drawing on the iPad Pro. Plus me, I'm an illustrator. I like vector-based art, which is really nice for me instead of drawing on Procreate, which is iPad's best drawing app, which is pixel based. There is vector based apps within the iPad, but I refuse to use them because there's nowhere near as good as quality to Procreate when it comes to pressure sensitivity and the way how the app functions. And it's just really nice. I can't wait till Procreate puts in a vector mode. Other than that, it's just really, really nice. And you really have to weigh out which software you're going to be using between either Illustrator, Photoshop, Affinity Design, Procreate, or anything else. And if you get a Cintiq, then it goes hand in hand with anything on the PC, since it just mirrors the computer screen onto your PC to the tablet, and so you're just able to function as if it's a second screen, which is super nice. But you really have to weigh out which one will work better for you. To me, I enjoy using both because I usually will sketch out things in Procreate, get a really nice, beautiful looking sketch going, and then I'll bounce it over to Illustrator and then finalize it there with the beautiful colors, beautiful lines, and things like that, since it's pixel based in Procreate and vector based in Illustrator. But that is my opinion. But let's keep on going and move on to the next segment of this video, and that is gonna be, what are you trying to do? What are you trying to make versus being a professional versus being a hobbyist? Now, the reason why I say this is because people have distinctive tastes on what they're trying to create. They're trying to create as a profession, as in school. They go through schooling just so they can go through and get a high-end job being a graphic designer. Then, by all means, get the best of the best. You already know how to draw. You know what you're looking for. Then go ahead and get that nice 27-inch Cintiq, you know. Then I do suggest that. But if you're just someone who's just, you know, getting into it at home, just wanting to start to try something new, a new type of hobby to get into, you know how to draw on paper really well, and you want to try something out and expand yourself, then go on ahead, get yourself a lower end Intuous Pro. You can get them used for low prices. You can get iPad Pros for low prices. I got an iPad Pro 2 or the third generation for below $500, which was amazing. And I got Apple Pencil, and I started plugging away, and I used that over a Cintiq just because it was cheaper. And I do appreciate using the higher quality items versus the lower end items, just because there's a huge difference in detail when you're using either or, because of price sensitivity or a bunch of other aspects. But you really have to look at yourself and ask yourself, what are you doing? Are you doing this for work? Are you doing this just for fun or for YouTube? Are you trying to make a professional job out of this, become a designer for printing of some sort? Maybe you're going to be making logos for companies. Really ask yourself what you're trying to do. But then after that, let's get on to the next and final subjects of the video, and that is going to be budget and then my final summary. So to weigh everything out is going to be also budget. You really need to play a key role in the budget, because you might not have the spending money. These items are very expensive. You can go to Best Buy and buy a Cintiq for like $600 plus, or you can go buy Intuos Pro for like $400 plus. Or if you know, if you're smart, you'll go online and get a used one for like half price. I got my Intuos Pro. It's a medium size. It's the closest, it's the most newest generation one for Intuos Pros, and I got that for what, like $100. It was amazing. I got my iPad Pro with the Apple Pencil. It's a second generation iPad Pro, 32 gig. It's the 11 inch one, and I got that for $350, which is an amazing deal for everything. And I do recommend that you guys really check out the budget before you guys start plundering all your money, because sometimes if you buy something, you might not be able to take it back, and so you're just stuck with this device, and you might not like it, and you want to take it back, and you try something, and you're not going to get your money back, and so it hurts you. But when it comes down to it, to my final summary, if you're trying to go from getting like an Intuos Pro to a hardened drawing tablet versus a screened drawing tablet, I just recommend you get both. You know, start off small, you know, get a lower end Intuos Pro. It don't gotta be the top tier model. Just get like something small model, medium model, which is what I did, and then upgrade yourself as you get used to it to the screen, which would be something like an iPad Pro to an Cintiq Companion or a Huion drawing screen, and just really get a good feel for it once you get a good hang of what you're trying to do. If you're just doing logos, if you're just drawing people all the time, if you're just wanting to sketch and coloring things on Photoshop, doing digital painting, then by all means, I say get both. And I have both. I truly do use both of them. I use them hand to hand. Whenever I go anywhere, I have the iPad. That's why I got the iPad, because it's super light, super versatile, and I can just use it anywhere, and the battery lasts a really good long time. I can draw for days in a row without putting a charge onto it, and it's just a lot of fun. And I highly recommend you guys do try both of them out. Definitely purchase both of them, try them out. If you don't like them, take them back if you're able to take them back. But that will conclude this video. But this is your boy Dominzs here at Common Sense Graphics. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Your boy out. Rate, comment, subscribe.